Beautiful intro cinematics aside, let's discuss a story of tragedy, which is sure to invoke a layer of emotional disgruntlement through to the very end. A movie that is about themes of loss and how to recover from that loss. A movie that I and anyone else who has experienced loss can relate to and get into a solemn mood while watching. A movie with gorgeous animation, with beautiful cinematic transitions, a story of characters with unrequited love, and most of all, a story of returning back to normal from a tragic event in your life. A time in your life that makes you feel so very alone and trapped in an endless vortex of not feeling alive anymore. All of these emotions are those that people have experienced or will experience in their lifetime, and this movie shows the process of healing and being yourself again beautifully as it builds up to this beautiful climax. Anyway, let me start off by telling the story of this movie. And obviously, if you don't want spoilers, please don't watch. I really recommend the movie. We get introduced to Hinako, who's this unorganized, carefree, clutter-minded girl whose apartment can essentially exemplify her very being. And the sheer number of boxes she has makes you wonder if she's a simple surfer girl or a mob boss moving drugs across the border. Anyway, jokes aside, I digress. Just know that she's a very sweet, yet clumsy girl who can surf well. After her introduction, her apartment catches on fire due to local goons who set off illegal fireworks. The fire department is called, and one of the firefighters on duty is her future lover, Minato, who we later find out is essentially her antithesis. He's a good cook, he has his life together, and has aspirations for the future, wanting to be a firefighter. Minato saves Hinako, and they decide to build a friendship while Hinako teaches Minato how to surf. While on the way to the first surfing session, they sing a song that is very prevalent throughout the movie and becomes a song that connects them, as well as showing their love life evolve. Numerous events go on, including them going to a town Christmas event where you can broadcast a message to the town about someone or something, whether that includes a love message or Merry Christmas. Hinako eventually meets Minato's younger sister and discovers that she is a pessimistic and blunt teen who will say what she sees. She commonly repeats the phrase "love is stupid" and is teased by Minato. Another notable character is Aito, who is Minato's firefighter friend, who secretly has feelings for Hinako, which will later come up. Now that you have a decent understanding of main characters and key plot points, I'll explain the tragedy that these events lead up to. After Minato sneaks out to get better at surfing and surprise Hinako, it is discovered that he unfortunately passed away trying to save somebody. We see this take a very heavy toll on Hinako, who will barely eat or talk, the very contrast to her outgoing, happy nature that we usually see. This is until she sings the song that used to comfort them the most, revealing that every time she does this, she will see Minato in a source of water that is closest to her. While she tells people this, they think she's gone crazy and won't accept the fact that he passed away. Eventually, Ito, Minato's friend, confesses his feelings to Hinako. It is revealed that Minato wants her to move on and find someone, not to be hung up on the past because he can't provide her the care she needs. Minato's younger sister, Yoko, and Hinako eventually get word that the same bad people who set off illegal fireworks in her apartment would be doing this again in an abandoned building. They go to stop them, but get caught in the building with flames surrounding them. As all seems hopeless, the spirit of Minato helps them out as he uses the water that the firemen spray at the building as a way to get Hinako and Yoko out of the building. Yoko gets to see her brother again, and this is the last time anyone sees Minato as his character arc. As he began a hero, ends as a hero. Time goes by and we see Yoko's in a relationship with Ito, saying her common phrase differently now as she says not being in love is stupid. Three are all at the same Christmas event a year later, and Hinako, looking for closure with Minato, gets some as a sound from the speaker says, "Merry Christmas, Hinako. Let's spend every Christmas together from this day forward." We then see later on that she has filled her aspirations, being the hero she wanted to be, but in the form of a lifeguard. She lets go of the past and moves forward as a new and improved person, because everyone looks for a future and meaning to their life, whether that be through conventional means, success, or just overall happiness with those that you love. Hinako chooses to be a hero, being inspired by Minato, and after experiencing this roller coaster of emotions, she finally became one. The amount of character development and separate character arcs that fit this movie are the reasons why it's underrated and why I love it. Anyway, thanks for watching, and be sure to check out this guy's music. He played the piano for this video, and wow, it is amazing. Alright, see ya.